Thank you. That was by Lynn Marsh. She wrote it in the 90s. Inspired, not really the word, but during the conflict in the former Yugoslavia. And I think you'll agree that the text, she also, like Philip Wilsey and Alan Simon, writes her own lyrics. And I think you'll agree they're extremely moving and challenging for such a young group. Now, the more discerning among you may have noticed that the side that was singing the top part in the first half is now singing the lower part. How many of you noticed that? Nothing I do with the training choir is too high for an alto or too low for a soprano. And of course, at this age, very few young people are yet altos in any case. So nothing is too high for anybody in this choir, nothing is too low. But everybody needs to get used to singing in harmony, singing a lower part, singing a desk part. And this is why I give everybody the chance to sing both parts. So it's very important, and this is what the training choir is all about. So, am I right, kids? This side is now the lower part. Yes, okay, I have to get used to it. Now, we were, as John said, totally and utterly inspired by Paul Whitaker. This following song by Bob Chilcott was actually inspired by Paul Whitaker. Bob saw Paul working and decided to write this song, Can You Hear Me? It is life through the eyes of a deaf person. Paul taught me and my junior choir, Rastrick, 10 years ago, the signing to this song.